In this video, we'll see how to use the MobilityGen extension in IsaacSim to generate robot trajectory data. This data is used to train mobility policies for different robot embodiments. So go to the Window tab on top and go to Extensions and type in MobilityGen UI in the search bar. Here, you can enable the extension by just toggling it on, and you'll see it open up on the right of your IsaacSim window. So it has a couple of fields here that we need to fill in. For stage, it expects the scene that we want to load. So for this on the left, let's go over to our simple warehouse scene and copy the path from there. So you can just right click and copy path for the warehouse multiple shelves USD, and then paste that over in the stage tab in MobilityGen. Now for occupancy map, it expects the map file that we recorded previously. So let's go to our map.yaml, copy the path from there, and then copy it over to the occupancy map. Now for robot type, we want to do a humanoid. So let's click on the H1 robot. And scenario type, let's do random path following. So it will generate random paths every few seconds. And then let's click on build. So let's give this a few seconds, a few minutes to load. Basically what it will do is load that scene and the robot within it. And then it will start based on what we've selected as the scenario type, which is random path following. We can start recording the data. Great. So here's our scene with the robot. And you can see the occupancy map as well on the right. We clicked on start recording. And this starts recording whatever we're seeing here in our simulation. So we see the robot starting from some random positions and walking towards a random goalpost as well. And because we've selected random path following, it'll do this multiple times until we hit stop recording. So it'll keep spawning random trajectories for the robot to follow. And in each trajectory, we see that the robot is able to avoid collisions because it knows exactly where the obstacles are in this scene based on the occupancy map. So it knows to go around these obstacles to avoid collisions. And you can see in the right at the top, the occupancy map shows this trajectory in green as well. So this helps. In simulation, you're able to quickly create different scenes. You're able to create an occupancy map, which shows exactly where obstacles are in this environment. And then you can have your simulated robot walk around inside the environment without colliding against anything. So here we just saw a new trajectory being recorded. It's also great to modify certain parameters. So this environment, for example, is a slightly darker one. There's more dim lighting. So data like this helps the robot become robust to these conditions as well, dimly lit environments, for example. And as an example here, we can hit stop recording, but of course you can continue recording as many scenes as you want. Here we stopped at 4, and for each trajectory, now you see a bunch of information in your project. So you see the occupancy map, along with the YAML file. Now let's go back to the documentation. So here is the tutorial we've been following. And you can go to the replay and render, copy that script. At this point, we'll be seeing the data that we just collected. What does it actually look like once it's rendered in simulation? So we copied over that code. It runs the standalone example script called replay directory. And we can go ahead and run that. The objective over here is for us to see, once rendered, what does this data look like from the robot's point of view. So eventually we want the robot point of view data collected, and we can augment that as well to be able to train robot policies for perception and mobility. So we've launched this script. It will take a couple of minutes or a couple of seconds, but it does it entirely in this window. So you don't need to go change parameters or change anything in the GUI. What the script does is it will render all of these data trajectories that we just collected. And it will output a bunch of files, image files for us to see from the robot's point of view for each trajectory. This takes a couple of minutes, so you can just let the script run. Great, and once it's done, it'll say a simulation app shutting down. So now we can go to the replace folder that's been generated. Let's go into any one trajectory, go into state, RGB, and click on robot front camera left RGB. So as the name suggests, this is the point of view from the front left camera of the robot from the eye perspective. And this is what it looks like. So it's a collection of images here that together form the entire trajectory. In addition to these RGB images, we also have some depth images that were captured, almost as if from a RGBD camera. And all of this data together is something you could capture in the real world, but capturing in simulation is just so much easier and quicker. And then you can use these for training robot policy models.